always his work my father cared about. His research. He tried to save his work. I tried to save him.
Hello there. Sir from 17 once again, introducing you to my Gears of War 3 Insane Difficulty video walkthrough. And this is Act 2, Chapter 5, Hijack. And as soon as you start this, you're going to be thrown into the ship with the enemies that I affectionately hate, known as Screamers. And they're basically flying ball sacks that shoot really automatic weapons at you. They're super annoying because they fly around, and when they die, they do a kamikaze dive run at you. So you need to be careful, because if that thing lands anywhere near you on Insane, you're going to die. But this first section isn't too bad, because you have the high ground and you have a lot of cover, so you need to make the most of it. And situations like this, especially when you've got the ability to have an advantageous position over the enemy, generally make the firefight a little bit easier. But it doesn't mean that it's simple, so just be as intelligent as you can. You know, use the weapons to your advantage and know that this level gets real bad towards the end. But I'm sure you'll be able to get through it, because somebody's just dropped a comment on one of my videos saying that they've beat it on Insane, so I've got all respect for that guy, because it isn't easy, and hopefully everybody else will have the same kind of patience that he's shown, because some parts of this game, they're just clinically wrong. So now it's quiet a little bit. I know where the last guys are. I'm waiting to try and get that headshot with a sniper rifle, but my buddy's just too busy shooting him, and he's jiving and dancing, and he just doesn't stand much of a chance. And I've got another disappointment with Gears as well, which kind of sucks. The arcade mode, I was super stoked and looking forward to it. And it's fun, it's cool, but you don't get ribbons. And if anybody's wondering what the ribbons are, because you've not played it yet, they're the equivalent of those tiny medals that you get on Halo when you do something cool. And they don't pop up in arcade mode, and they totally should. They really should, it's not fair. But Epic decided to leave it out. Hopefully they'll patch it in. Who am I to tell them what to do, but I would like them to. It would be quite nice. So these are the Theron Guards, or the Royal Guards, depending on your opinion. They have those pointy hats, and the Therons generally didn't. The Therons just had kind of those, like, oval hats, so I do believe they are Royal Guards. They have talk bows, so if you hear that winding talk bow sound, get in cover. You never want to be out of cover when they fire that, because they will tag you so quickly, and there's nothing you can do once you've been hit by a talk bow. Your character just accepts his own death, because they generally go something like, "Oh shit," and then blow up. And it's really funny, but I would take a Theron or a Queen's Guard any day with a Talkbow than a Lancer, because as soon as he's fired, he can't do anything. And you can really take advantage of that by either running up to them and beating them up and shooting them or whatever, or just sniping them, because they have to winch it so long. They have to start charging, and then fire. And you can definitely take advantage of that, because for some reason they don't know how to charge the Talkbow for like 2 seconds and then fire. They have to keep it winched. It's kind of weird. But when you move down here, first thing you'll notice me doing is I'm really paranoid towards this door, because I think a bunch of diggers turn up, or there's a bunch of something. But there you go, pick the Talkbow up. From now on, you'll have a Talkbow. This is a one-shot, one-kill on most enemies. If you can headshot them, it's pretty much a one-shot, one-kill on everything. It's just, headshotting with a Talkbow is an art form, and it can be very difficult to do sometimes. But boomers, grinders, maulers, all those kind of guys, they will go down from one shot if you have it in their face. The standard stuff will die from it anywhere. And I'm not too sure about the corpses. I've not really used it on them. I just hit Dom then, because he was in the fucking way. And that pissed me off, because as good as the Talkbow is, you don't get that much ammo for it. So you want to make every shot count. And if Dom's gaining the way, he's not helping. But there's your digger. There's the first. There's two diggers. You see him to the right. Get out of the way as quick as you can. There it is. Goodness me, they're so deadly. But just keep hitting them. I think two Talkbows text these guys down. That's one of them done. If you can hit his head, though, you can full on get that satisfying pop. But I just couldn't do it. So I'm just going to move away from his digger launcher. Then go back in and take him on. But the only problem with this guide so far is how long it is and how difficult it's been to upload, because my internet at this moment in time is real bad. The cool thing is I'm about to go back at university where they have fantastic internet which I can use, but I want to get this guide up before I go then. It's kind of like a catch-22. Never rush too far in when screamers are about because they are a pain in the ass. The only time where the screamers are even remotely docile is at the last boss until the last phase when they come absolutely deadly. And they make it complete and utter hell because you're trying to escape a boss that can one-hit kill you and they're gradually weaning down your life and you can't find cover. It's just terrible. But there's a guy in a troika over there. If you can hit him with the talk bow, you will kill him. The only problem is sometimes it takes two because it's armoured. If you can headshot him, he will die in one. Did I get him? I don't think I did. Has he got on the turret? Yeah, he has. A good place to shoot for is the thigh when they're on the turret. If you're not confident in getting the head, shoot for the thigh. I think there's just one guy left over there, and I'm all out of talk ammo now, so there you go. But, luckily enough, this section you can take it from a good vantage point. Be careful as you push up, because you never know who's left. That's the one mistake I make probably more than anything else, is when I rush up, and in a corner there's a dude up against cover smiling at me, and on the insane, you're probably going to die at that kind of range. But, there should be a digger reload, but I don't think I grab it. Oh, wow. That's what the digger can do. It's such a fun weapon when you get used to it. But I would definitely say go for the talk bows. If any of these guys drop to talk bows, pick them up. It's going to pay dividends later on. In fact, there's a section coming up where you have to wait for a barge to land that is complete and utterly insane. And the talk bow comes in handy for that. But that bit is bullshit, and the only strategy I'm going to be able to give, aside from what you'll see, is luck and pray, because it's bullshit. But once this is done, you can run over to the door straight in front of me. I come up here to see if there's any collectibles or anything. I don't think there is. And if there were, they've already been taken. And then we can carry on with this level. Do apologise if I'm sounding a bit gruff, guys. I've just woken up, cleared my throat, what have you, my sinuses are playing up, and I'm just sipping on my first beverage of the day. Boy, does it taste glorious. But here we are, back inside. Back into the tunnels that the locusts have been digging, these little encampment, stronghold, whatever you want to call it. And there is a retro lancer, so I'll be grabbing that. And you see, I had a strategy for this bit, what's coming up, because I knew it was going to be bad. And I knew if I had the retro lancer I could stun them, but it didn't work that way at all when I got there. So don't pick the retro lancer up, keep the normal lancer, because this bit coming up with this lift, this is also just like the zipline section. This is one of the hardest parts of the game. It's completely luck dependent, it's ridiculously broken and unbalanced, and if you don't like being insta-killed, you're not going to like this moment. And get used to seeing this checkpoint here, because this is where it starts you every time you die. I hate it, you'll hate it. I'll see you in the next video, guys. You take care now.